Welcome to the slaughter at Gaines's Mill. I'm playing Ultimate General Civil War on Major General Difficulty using the JMP mod. This is the Union Campaign. So this battle requires two corps with up to 24 brigades in one and 12 brigades in the other. I have my Major General as my first corps commander. Initial deployment will include the first three divisions plus the 1st Brigade and the 4th Division. The rest of 4th Division will come in as early reinforcements. 2nd Corps will be the last reinforcements. 1st Division and the first three brigades in 2nd Division will deploy to the forward area where the river crossing battle took place earlier in the campaign. The next 10 brigades will deploy behind the fortification in the area around Gaines's Mill. I had more skirmishers than I needed after the mobile forces set up that I used at Shiloh, so I merged several of them together. I had 42 brigades at Shiloh, but you can only take 36 to Gaines's Mill and Malvern Hill, and I don't like to have units sitting around not getting any XP in major battles, so I have exactly 36 now. I created some dedicated melee units at Shiloh, so all three of them will come in as my first reinforcements. With the melee perk, it will give them some extra speed to get into position before the CSA flank attack, along with a pair of carbine cav units. Second Corps are all my reinforcements, so I put a focus on speed there also, with many of my one-star skirmishers, two small cav units, and three horse artillery. Malvern Hill also requires reinforcements to come across the screen, so the horse artillery will be part of the reinforcements that deploy at that battle too. I bought 2,000 Lorenz rifles, 1,750 Springfield 61s, and 6 20-pound Parrots during the side battles leading up to Gaines's Mill. I also bought long-range skirmisher weapons and all the heavy guns available so I can start converting my guns from medium to heavy after Malvern Hill. I also put all three career points from the side battles into logistics to start increasing my shop supply of heavy guns. I bumped the AI unit scaling up to 1.2 for Gaines's Mill and Malvern Hill. Since the CSA deploys very piecemeal, the numbers are a little deceptive because you only face about a third of their forces at any given time. We are going to start out by setting up a defensive perimeter just far enough off the river to be able to fire on the CSA as they try to cross. I will have my two skirmishers trip the two VPs, then get into position. Keep an eye on the 500-yard sniper unit in the far south. They're going to have over 2,000 kills by this time this is all done. I also bring my guns up to support my infantry. Lastly, I will send my cavalry to the far north to get into position to raise hell from the rear. The CSA won't flank on the right until later in phase 2, so you can focus all of your attention on the left for now. After this phase, I'll shift a handful of units over to the right to work with my reinforcements that come in to repel the flanking force. So whenever I buy a new game, I always play it through at least once without researching any strategies or anything like that. I just go by whatever the game tells you when you pop it in and start playing. So of course, I played the battle as intended, and it was a pain in the butt while being a nail biter at the same time. So this particular playthrough is some level of payback for what the AI did to me in those first couple of times that I played it. I only make one real mistake towards the end because I forgot about Jackson coming in very late and I thought the battle was over. Once you've taken the fight out of the initial CSA charges, you can cross the water and pursue them to destroy them, but if you do that, make sure that you get back across the water before the next phase of reinforcements arrives. I will let the battle play out and comment when the battle report pops up at the end. So I lost 7% of my forces. I worked my cav pretty hard here. The AI lost 64% of their forces. Obviously, the artillery had a big day, and my sniper unit put up over 2,000 kills. And I captured just over 5,000 Lorenz rifles. So, all in all, a pretty good outing. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you at Malvern Hill.